Good morning and welcome to the Daily News Trends on SSiTV Africa. South Africa records 17,493 new COVID-19 cases, 166 deaths. South Africa has recorded 17,493 new COVID-19 cases. The NICD said 166 COVID-19 related deaths have also been recorded. This brings total fatalities to 59,258 to date. Gauteng continues to account for the majority of infections with 10,806 cases in the last 24 hours. The positivity rate is 24.9%. A total of 70,186 tests were conducted in the last 24 hours. Sinopharm efficiency on trial in South Africa. Good news on the COVID-19 vaccine front. The SAFA is testing the efficiency of the Sinopharm jab. The manufacturers of the Chinese vaccine applied to the South African regulatory body to authorize emergency use. It's the second Chinese vaccine after Sinovac being tested by SAHPRA. The Russian-made Sputnik vaccine is also being investigated. There have been battles between vaccinologists and the COVID-19 Ministerial Advisory Committee on which vaccines to use in South Africa. Tyres fires lasers, Palestinians smoke out settlers. With flashing lasers, honking horns and choking smoke from burning tyres, the latest tactics used by Palestine protesters are dusk till dawn rallies to make life unbearable for Israeli settlers. "They will not stay on our land," said one protester, a scarf wrapped around his face to conceal his identity from Israeli troops near the small Palestinian town of Beita in the occupied West Bank. Across the valley is the newly built Israeli settlers' outpost of Evitar. "We will continue to do this until the smoke from the rubber hits their ruins," he said. When the Palestinians come too close to the outpost, Israeli soldiers fire tear gas to drive them back. Then, as dawn breaks, everyone goes home to catch some sleep, ready to start once again at dusk. FDA to add heart risk warning to mRNA vaccines. The Food and Drug Administration on Wednesday said it will add a warning about rare cases of heart inflammation in teens and young adults to fact sheets for the Pfizer, BioNTech, and modern COVID-19 vaccines, that the benefits greatly outweigh the risks and are still recommending the vaccine for all Americans over 12 years old. CDC advisory groups found the risk of the heart condition in adolescents and young adults in likely linked to the mRNA vaccine, and that the risk is notably higher after the second dose and in males. Doctors and hospitals have been warned by the CDC to watch for symptoms of myocarditis or pericarditis, and the FDA warning will further raise awareness. But in a Wednesday meeting, advisors said the benefits of the mRNA vaccine appeared to clearly outweigh the risks. Cape Pennsylvania University of Technology to study youth's lack of interest in voting. The CPUT, Cape Pennsylvania University of Technology, Journalism Department says they will be researching why many young people show a lack of interest in voting. The Electoral Commission of South Africa in the Western Cape has launched their 2021 local government election in collaboration with the CPUT Journalism Department. Some activities of the collaboration will include election preparation, election day activities, group discussions on elections for the youth, and research. Journalism lecturer at the CPUT, Tisanda Nkoala, says it is important to find out why some young people are reluctant to vote. Soaring temperatures prompt changes to US Olympic trial schedule. Extreme heat conditions with temperature expected to reach more than 37.7 Celsius had led officials to make changes to the schedule for the US Olympic trials in Eugene, Oregon at the weekend. Most affected are the distance races, with the women's 10,000 meters moved to 10 a.m. local time on Saturday and the men's 5,000 meter to the same time on Sunday. USA Track and Field said the changes were made with regard to athlete safety while competing in high temperatures, as well as officials, fans and staff attending the event. The men's and women's 20-kilometer race walks and had previously been moved up to 7 a.m. on Saturday following forecasts for scorching temperatures at the weekend. The U.S. election trials for next month's Tokyo Olympics conclude on Sunday. Thank you for tuning in on the Daily News Trends.